comes all. Adjusting volume here. Hey, Quarterman, how's it going? Seeing how levels are. Levels look decent. Alright. So, hello, this is Twitchy Tuesday with Simorgu on DDO stream. That's me here now. It's Tuesday. And, let's see what we're doing today. So, looks like I need to probably start doing 13s. I was kind of doing the 11s, 10s just to get my XP started, but now I'm have level 16, I just need to take it. Might as well bank it and proceed. Now I can start getting bravery bonuses and running at level and all that fun stuff. I was kind of avoiding that just to get the run up, because I knew I might have problems keeping that going. Crucible. Enemy within. I think I did that already. Crucible, though. Crucible might be interesting to get out of the way. I don't really like Giant Bolt, but I don't know if I can say no to Crucible. Presuming that's at level, which I think it is. Oh, no, it's not. It's not at level. It's level 14. I can wait a while for that. Never mind. So, I'm going to start insulting Summerfield then. But while I'm here, go ahead and get this stuff taken. We'll have to do it later. I don't have teleport on this character, so I have to walk back up. So yeah, exciting stuff going on. All preview stuff coming, and all this new feats and levels and stuff. It's an exciting time to be playing DDO. Lots of fun stuff happening. I'm at the bank and I want to be at thing. While I'm here, I'll get that. No, it's right there. I was going to go the wrong way. I don't usually walk this way to get there. Oh, yeah. So, do I already have Summerfield? Summerfield is this one. Summerfield is. Yeah, that's what we want to see. Bravery bonus, first time completion bonuses, daily playthrough bonuses, all the bonuses. That's what we're looking for. Oh, I need to turn some stuff on. Stone skin just to be fun. Make sure I shining through.
Summerfield is ablaze.
All right.
Black smoke pours from countless buildings. Atop the hastily built defensive walls, you spy an elf giving the sound of pillage echo off the remaining city walls. Unless you stop the Droam army, Summerfield's fate will be shared by every district in Stormreach. Eldritch portals open along the building ledges. It has begun their new assault.
I actually survived. I'm impressed. He didn't. Oh, he did. This blade lock, well, it's Jotmon's porcupine build, basically, but I really enjoy playing this. It's a lot more survivable than Shaw was as a fighter monk.
Moments pass without portals appearing. While the Droam army commander reformulates his strategy,
oh yeah, and I lost my chat settings. I keep forgetting to redo those. I had like 6 or 7 windows. I guess I didn't realize those got nuked with you. Sure. Incarnating. Yay, mysterious remnants.
Working fountain in the Summerfield district.
We're getting a lot more monster chunks. So I'll be doing a lot more at level stuff. Nice because the warlock stuff basically takes the place of cleaves. So I still have my cleaves that I had as a fighter. So I can do some just wading in and killing a bunch of guys at once. I'm still two-handed with great axes, so that didn't change too much. The difference is I can actually heal myself. And I don't need a bunch of temporary hit points. Like so.
The beating war drums.
Time to reinforce the defenses. Start.
I would never have felt comfortable soloing this at level with Shaw. Not at all. Oops. The bane of gamers, the small rock or ledge. It should be just a quick step automatically, and is not. I'm not picking on DDS specifically for that, but that happens in a lot of games. And it's annoying wherever it happens. Kind of breaks the immersion a bit. Especially if it's inconsistent. As in, some rocks might just do that and some don't. Which I believe is the case in DDO. Hey Titan, how's it going? Oh, actually, I'll get that while I'm thinking about it. Otherwise I'll forget. Probably go this one first, if I can see where he is. Lots of stuff in the way. So I can check in some of those buildings. I know sometimes you find stuff in there. I don't know these quests super well. I've started to run them more. Get used to them. But, like that random guard on a bookshelf. I really want my guild to convert to Discord. I'm liking Discord a lot more than TeamSpeak. One reason, it's got sort of a Slack chat built in. Another is it has an overlay if you use DDO DirectX 9, which is kind of annoying because I have this new machine that's DirectX 11 compatible, and DDO looks beautiful in DirectX 11. I don't really want to drop back to DirectX 9, but I want the overlay. It's one of the really cool features. As you can see, he's talking in your channel and stuff. So. Guard hidden back here. How do you manage to close that trap behind him? Where's that spot? I didn't think I'd get it, but I wanted to check to make sure. Yeah, and there's a general DDO Discord channel that spaghetti/moffle put together. It has a couple streamers and other various people in it. There's another guard. I'll switch to ranged. I love having that option too. Don't do great damage range, but it's decent. And switch back to aura. I like the whole temporary invite thing, and you can do a whole bunch of really interesting stuff with Discord. Hope it lasts. Let's see. That's the captain. I guess I could go kill the ballista and such. Or whatever those are. In the back, let's see, I think I went in that one already. Getting turned around. This is where I want to go.
Droam's army has set up forward command posts on this side,
I'm excited. I ordered a steam machine last night. There was that really great sale on the Siberia ones. Cyber ones, whatever they're called. And, 200 bucks off, I couldn't pass it up. Even though I'm pretty sure I'm getting a shield and a Steam Link for the holidays. And a Steam controller. But hey, multiple stuff, choices, it's cool. Hey, Mandrill Sims, how's it going? Pretty well this evening. Thanks for stopping by. Bought a TV over the weekend. There was a sale. I had a gift card from when we bought our appliances. So it was a nice 40-inch Samsung smart TV for like 200 bucks. Then went to Harbor Freight and got a mount. Now the guest bedroom has a TV that can do Netflix and such. I didn't really notice my hands going down that much. There's some shams here. That I had to go to Home Depot and get some bolts, because the bolts isn't supplied with the kit, it didn't exactly work with the physical dimensions design of the TV. I had to use some spacers, and they provide spacers, but they don't provide bolts long enough to actually use the spacers, which is kind of odd. So I had to get some slightly longer bolts to do that. It's up. I played with it a little bit, did a firmware update or a software update, of course, because everything that's software has to have an update before you use it. And I watched some YouTube videos just to make sure it worked. I really want to try the Wi-Fi Direct, where you basically use it as a Chromecast and put whatever's on your phone on the TV. Is this where the buried chest is? Oh, there it is. I am 15. Level 15 bolt. I think I got all those guys down. Break more crates. The collectible junk. I think I'm done back here. So I need to find two more guards. We'll use left hand roll. Actually, we can go up here and see if any are visible. There's one. Oh, those are the live ones, aren't they? Yeah, those are the live ones. Bookshop, which I think I've been in. Alright, none more visible from here. There's fungus I didn't get yet. Some crates I didn't get yet.
mobs engulfing the battering ram are too hot to brave. Another path through the district would be advisable.
Been up there. I want to skip that back there for the moment. There's a crate I didn't get. Come back to this section. Use right hand roll. Been in that one. I'm pretty sure I've been in that one. What's that one? Basement apartment. I'm pretty sure I was in that one. I'm not 100% sure, but pretty sure. I don't think I've been in this one, though. Jerk. I'm trying to search for something. How rude. Interrupted me. Like that. There's a guard. Yay, found all the guards. So really, there's only one left. Shouldn't be too bad to get that one. Aggression. We don't even. Oh man. Need more breakables. I don't think I did the ones up near the guard at the top. That's probably what they're missing. There's the guard. Yay. All the breakables there. Done my there yet? Okay, finally got mischief. Anyway, with that steam machine I'm getting, there was a couple cheap upgrades, and then there was a handshake mouse, if you guys know what that is. Or vertical mouse, whatever you call it. And I looked around online, and the price, like Amazon and other places, was like three times what it was to buy it with the machine, so I went ahead and got one. Here to try it out, because right now my wrist is killing me. My desk here needs to be up or down, or my chair needs to be higher. I need to do something so my wrist doesn't kill me. I am not ergonomic at the moment. I really need to be. Hey, blind jump through the smoke worked. Alright, there's a captain. Let's go down here and make sure you've broken all the breakables. You can see extra 2% at least. If I can find the rest of them. I haven't broken yet.
Rank odors from the Stormreach sewer system waft up from this hatch.
Yeah.
Sewer tunnel beyond this hatch.
You know, I was thinking the same thing, because that's really cheap for a PlayStation TV, but if I'm playing Vita games, I'm playing them on my Vita. And that's because it's mobile, and yeah. I don't really want to play my Vita games on the TV. Now, I guess if I wanted to stream them, that would be good. But, yeah. I really don't see the need for a PlayStation TV. But $20 is a great deal for it. If I could justify it in any way, I would have gotten one. But even the SO plays stuff on Vita, and we play on Vita, we're playing mobile. In bed or
traveling or something. We're not playing at home in front of the TV usually. Or if we are, there's something else on TV already. So it just doesn't make a lot of sense. Yeah, if you wanted another YouTube Netflix machine, that'd be a good use for it. I don't really know what's compatible and what isn't with SteamOS. I'm looking forward to playing around with it. The Shield is Android TV, so I'll have that to play with. My third Android TV device, hopefully this one's better than the other two. Just as you try engaging the we'll see. I'm wanting to get a way to play stuff not sitting here at the desk. So that's why I'm kind of experimenting with all this stuff. But I can get it for a decent price or as a gift. Well, I could probably use more hit points. That's something I need to play with is I need to get my Vicade into a workable state for games. I don't know if I want to replace the Raspberry Pi with something else or what. I want to do something to make it better. Maybe if I can compile a new version of the Vicade stuff, it'll be in better shape than the last I played with it.
A scream of rage echoes off the city walls as he falls dead.
Oh, I got Vandal. I'll take it. Oh, I got a mark this time. Still no. I need that popsicle. Is that popsicle not dropped? I tried to farm this in several characters and just have not been getting it. Kind of annoying. But yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing what emulators do, playing around with the Steam controller and see how that works. We're going to hang, we got another mount, so we're going to hang the plasma. We have a 40-inch plasma TV, hanging that in our rat room, which is also a secondary guest room, but we hang out there with the rats and let them run around. And so it's nice to have, it'll be nice to have something to do in there when the rats are being shy or not interactive with us. Something to watch Twitch on in the background or something. So, yeah. Bunch of junk. Undermine isn't next, is it? I mean, I'll do it next, but I didn't think it was next. I thought Blockade Buster was next. Yeah, let's go do Blockade Buster first. I'm gonna go back here real quick. But the plasma has another problem. Because, like, you know, the new TV we got was like 20 pounds. The plasma is like 90 pounds. So, and the bolt holes are way recessed. So none of the bolts fit at all. And I need to get really long bolts to fit in there. So. I'm not even sure if they're M6s or M8s. I don't know what the thread pitch is.
So I'm hoping they're M8 1.25s in about 35 or 40 millimeter. And I hope that'll work. I'm gonna go try to find some of those. But I found out that the close Home Depot is not the one that has all the screws and bolts and stuff. It's the one a little further away. So you need to go there and get all that stuff done. Hopefully, in the next couple days, I'll get that done and get that on the wall. And then when everything arrives, I can figure out what goes where. I'll have a steam machine, I'll have a shield, and I'll have a steam link. I'm also going to figure out what to do here. I want to get another monitor set up so I can look at chat and such while streaming. And the SO pretty much told me to go do that.
The Droam fleet has gathered
Go get
here
one and
this
mount it
dark
above your
night,
ultra-wide
hoping for
monitor so you can
mutual
watch chat.
protection.
And then figure out if I'm
Such
going to
measures
replace this
might
desk
help
with one of
against a
the
naval attack,
IKEA
but
ones that
not
raise and
against
lower,
you.
or do something else. But I need to figure something out. Oh, you know what would have been a really great idea is to buff up before I start the quest. Not after I'm already in the quest. Play DDO next to each other on the couch or something for kill night, which is something we're missing since we got the desktop. More on different floors. Miss the couch side by side. That's a requirement to figure out somewhat soon. I'm hoping one of these things will help with that. Maybe use this steam link or shield play DDO downstairs.
Raids against the civilized peoples of Corvair came to Zendric only to die by your hand.
Interesting. I don't remember that item.
This is the private quarters of Bash, the ogre veteran of the last war. It appears to be unoccupied at the moment.
Nothing, huh? So it's not the quarters. Hello. Let's try down here. Oh, this is probably not. This is usually the
All is quiet in the lower decks.
deadly ambush. Where you have people piling up dead. Oh, I killed those guys pretty fast. They shouldn't have been able to do the alarm.
The
Don't
hatch
have the
to the
crest
mine
yet.
bay looks like it requires some kind of crest to unlock. It's likely the lower decks of the carnage is abuzz with
Anything?
activity. The entire crew was awakened by the alarm.
So we'll go this way. Must be in the cavern. Yep, there it is.
take a line from one of the bosses. Why are you still alive? Ooh, should be dead. Oh, it's not the right place. Over here.
The hatch to the mine bay looks like it requires some kind of crest to unlock. It's likely secure. From bays like this, the Droam fleet has deployed enough mines to stop all shipping in storage. If you can get past the mines, you can find a way to get the mines. This panel controls the detonators on all the mines from the Vengeance, both those already deployed in the water and those still here in this bay.
Let's see how fast I can get out of here. Hopefully fast enough to avoid being identified. Yay. Let's get a nice view of the explosion.
One down, two to go.
I think some things didn't explode correctly.
Even the deepest slumbering Droam soldier would have awoken from that explosion.
That's hilarious.
The remaining Droam forces will now be alert to your presence.
See, a little bit of something still there. Didn't get blown up correctly. Hi, guys. Oops. Stuck into the galley. Chunks. Annoying, you have to be right on top of those. Only so many guys in the ship. They were all awakened earlier, so ring that bell. Yeah, it really does. These guys up here are shipping a little bit more difficult to deal with. I'm just gonna recall, fix that now. The crest I needed. So really, you should get all the breakables if you destroy all the ships automatically, right? If everything's broken once it explodes.
From here, the Vengeance uses a complex system of rails and pulleys to
over the Kildarius, my warlock blast bursts things, or my cleaves. They serve the same basic purpose. Probably actually do more damage than I would otherwise. Some of the investment I have in them. There we go. I did it again. That piece of shadow there you can't actually step on. There we go. And it turns out you really don't need cleaves. So, I think the melee is there just between your blasts, bursts. Let me get on this ladder and I'll switch over to where the build is. That's the build I'm using. Blast, you jerk. Man, that's brave. Give me my chunks. We'll go ahead and get these guys dead. Just so they're not annoying me all the time. So that's the lower deck. Let's leave the lower deck for last. See if the captain's in his quarters. Let that happen, Titan. Not that it's a big deal to run. What's my jigger again? To get more.
For his vile ritual sacrifices of innocent lives has now fallen to your wrath.
Yeah, but where's the crest? Yeah, that can happen, some of those long quests that are hard. Hard difficulties, I mean. But that's why you do the ritual on them, so they don't perma break. Oh, poor guy spawned. Joyous. Did it actually? Kind of on autopilot sometimes. I don't realize what I'm doing. I mean, other things you might need to farm, those are just so simple to get new ones.
The Bloodlust's crew is awake down here.
Generally, you should have multiples of them anyway, so. They're so easy to get another. It's not like you have to farm and they randomly drop. It's you complete the chain and they drop, so it's not a big deal to get new ones. I'd be mad if it was something that I actually had farmed, like my cloak of invisibility. That would be
the hatch to the mine bay looks like it requires some
sucky
kind of
to have
crest
to
to
replace.
unlock.
Yep, there it is. I have the
It's
crest.
likely secured somewhere else on this ship. This is the Bloodlust's mine bay.
Mine
Put
bay?
The old engine to the
It's not yours bay, it's called mine bay. Come here, you jerk. Stop running. Alright, jerk heads. Stop spamming that stuff at me. How did that completely miss him? Those archers, though. Say goodbye, everybody. Yay.
Blockade of Stormreach Harbor.
Success. Now we can do Undermine. I don't know, Siege Breaker. It's a tough solo. It's doable, it's just annoying.
Undermine shouldn't be too bad. Let's remember to buff.
A deep rumbling sound emanates from a nearby corner of the plaza. Guard Captain Tullis appears worried.
Yeah, I wasn't knocked down.
Pay attention to my hit points again. Just because I can heal myself doesn't mean that it happens automatically. Still gotta watch. Why did that do that? Somehow I got off the wrong hotbar. Interesting. Like we're ready to go to the next part.
In the huge crater, a ladder and a tunnel lead off into the darkness. It shouldn't be too difficult to climb down. The construction of the tunnel shows it was quickly but professionally built.
Treasure bags.
Fellow kobolds, but he doesn't seem to care as long as the mines slow you down.
Of course he doesn't care. They're kobolds.
Yeah.
So many chunks, it's awesome. That's what I love about the aura. Even if you get knocked down, you're still doing damage. At this rate, I'll have double the chunks that I have by the time we get up to a decent level.
That huge explosion blocked for some reason. The
that huge explosion blocked for some reason.
Dig through this natural cavern. And instead chose to tunnel around. A dead Medusa lies sprawled next to a bin full of demolition charges.
Demolition charges, let's put them here.
After she met her sudden end, what manner of creature could have resisted the Medusa's stony gaze?
Maybe one that's made out of stone itself?
Rubble blocks your way out of this cavern.
Barney rubble?
There must be something here you can use to get past it.
This could be funny. Yep. Oh, great. Just enough to make it worthwhile. Didn't get me, which was would have been the really funny part. He actually got his crap in. Let's try that again. Had my health screen at work today, so I was hungry by the time it came around. The whole fasting thing. Blech. Found out I have to work next week, starting at 5 p.m. Monday and Tuesday. So I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to stream or not. I think I'll be able to. I just have to start a test and then kind of check in. I shouldn't have anything interactive, but we'll see. Nature of performance testing, sometimes you have to go off hours. Especially since we're doing it in production, which is always fun. Crimson Chain, I've seen that before. I got a fawn hair dye. Wanted a red one. Presumably hair dye works on Shade Archive. I really don't like having black hair on my bard at the moment. Doesn't seem right. Hey Rothko, how's it going? Hope you're doing well this evening. Welcome, thanks for stopping by. Good, glad to hear it. Check my phone here in a second. As soon as I have a place between other guys, I can do that. I do have a text message. Let me check this real quick. The SO is not happy about me having to work nights.
This cavern is crammed with supplies. It's a
as long as it's just 2 days, I'm not really. Generally, you don't want to miss production. Sometimes that's just how it has to happen. And this is one of those cases where no one had any better ideas on how to get this testing done. I've been ready to go for like 2 weeks now. Just waiting on them to get the approvals and firewall settings done, app web server settings done, and all that fun stuff needs to happen before I can actually test. I'm hoping everything's ready for me to go. I don't have any issues, because 5 p.m. is a bad time to start finding out you have issues. And of course, I have an 8 a.m. meeting on Monday to figure out their status, so hopefully by then they've figured out any issues I might have, and we'll have the rest of the day to fix them before I start at 5. But that's a theory, let's see how it actually works in practice. That's why we're testing, to figure out how it actually works. It should work. There shouldn't be any issues, but we're testing to make sure. This one's kind of fun. I was reading that everybody's top 10 in that forum thread. I was trying to think of what my top 10 would be. This one might make the list. I don't know. Party Crashers, Snitch, and Spies, of course, are on the list. But after those, I'm not really sure what else really. Most excellent. Do we feel like doing the optional? I think we do. We're going to do the optional. Top 10 best quests in the game or something like that. Let me tab over to my window and let me see if I can find it.
It was fairly recent. Really, it's this far back? Well, I thought it was more recent than this. Yeah, here it is. It's actually top 30 greatest quests in DDO. But it's basically a request for people to list their top 10. I agree with some of them, I don't agree with others, but that's how it's going to be. But I have to put Party Crashers and Spies and Snitch up in the up, probably in my top 10. Can't imagine it would be top 10. Cascade, you are not taking much damage. I haven't done haunted halls, but like twice, so I can't really say about haunted halls. I'm going to be playing it more probably shortly on Caniff once I get my character a higher level on there. But at the moment, I don't know. I don't think Temple of Elemental Evil is going to be on there either for me, because I've only done it a couple times and it just hasn't grabbed me. None of the Giant Hold stuff really grabs me. None of the Veiled stuff really grabs me. Probably the one Chanticleer with the traps would probably be a good one. Tempest Spine. Yeah, raids are inconsistent. I've seen people list raids and some people don't, so I don't know. If I was doing raids, it'd probably be a slightly different list than if I wasn't doing raids. Because I agree
Thick
about
smell
Tempest
of
Spine, it's
smoke
pretty
in the
cool.
air suggests the presence of explosives nearby, as does the charred corpse of an unfortunate ogre.
Yeah, Temple. I haven't done it much, and the second part is such a slog. The first part's not bad, but the second part is just, I mean, I'm glad it's there and it exists, but it's really long. Just, I don't have. Oh, I don't play it very much. Again, I've done it like two or three times. So the fun part about soloing this is if you screw up here, pretty much got to start over. Question is, how safe do I want to play it? But I agree, at Tempest Spine, Vaughn 5-6, if we're talking about raids, those in Shroud are at the top. I'd probably put Vaughn 5-6, then Shroud, then Tempest Spine.
there are some that are at the bottom of the list. And some I still haven't played yet, so I can't really say. I mean, like, Abbott's fascinating, but I've completed it maybe twice, three times. And that's rare, because it's a pain to flag for, and it isn't run very often, and all that stuff, so... Yeah. Jerk. And another one. Just for fun. And another one. Alright. That should be good to put another thing down. I could just jump, but then if I miss jump, I'm toast. If I had wings somehow, it'd be different, but I don't have wings. Do I? Or do I? Is that a feat or enhancement? Yeah, I don't have it. Don't have it yet. Getting there. Again, this is purely so that I don't have to restart. I don't feel like doing this all over again. Just because I made a misstep on one part. Probably gonna get knocked down. It's fine. Expecting that. You know, I still haven't done. The thing I need to do is go into the black lock and see if my computer slows down. I think, you know, if you're looking at your favorite quests, some of it's going to be how often do you run it, which means that in most cases it's good XP for the time investment. It's not just run-of-the-mill boring stuff. You have something interesting about it that makes you want to run it again, especially if you're talking multiple lives. And you can look at things like, you know, flagging. So I think I would like Abbott a lot more if the flagging wasn't such a pain. It's an interesting flagging mechanism that you run the same quest four times and get four different endings. That's neat, but it ends up being a real pain. Just like having to walk to all the giant hold stuff's a pain. It's a huge area to have to walk through everything. Might get hit here. Yep. That's perfect, though. No, that bounce isn't. I don't like how he's hitting me through the thing, but... Make sure I've got jump, make sure I'm hasted. I'm visited for fun, even though he knows I'm here. Hello, jump lag. You are really deadly. He fell.
least it wasn't me. Ooh, getting hit with some stuff. Should be okay still. I'm gonna worry about clearing those guys out because they're a pain to get to. I mean, I could range them, I guess. I'm kind of glad to be out of that area. It is down here and done a thing. Charge. Don't check your phone while you're in combat, kids. Demolition charges set up. Let's get some hit points up. Chunks. Oh, 61. That's a good haul for chunks. That boulder did not just reflex save, did it? Refresh this, one of these.
A familiar kobold voice barks. Blow them up! Blow them up now! You have found the magician's monster.
I'm at Vandal. That's good. Hello, got some damage. How about that? He goes doing his thing.
Weapons Master crumples to the ground. You've defeated Droam's scheme to undermine Stormreach.
Yay.
You've reached the end of the tunnel. Surely this
that was good XP.
Droam's base of operations here on Zendrick.
That's what I like to see. Starting getting the streak going. Oh. Starts being much better XP. Right back at the Coin Lord. I don't know why I'm chilling getting paintball notices from Nevada, but people keep signing up with my email address on stuff. It's annoying. Alright, we're flagged for Siegebreaker. Oops, it's the other one. Those are the giant hole ones I need to be doing. I'm going to go back to the ship before I do this. This one can be annoying. And I need to remember that I have that symbol of weakness. Just displacement on my helm, which will be useful. I don't use clickies that often. This whole extra XP after UTR thing is, interesting. Couldn't believe how long it took me to even get the stuff. Yep. Only one in my level range, anyway. There's a bunch more that aren't in my level range. But for level 15s, there's only one at the moment. Tempest Spine up. Chains of Flame, Therascrina, Crypt, Cypher. Rainbow in the Dark, Tracker's Trap. There was a mod up earlier I saw on one channel. Haste Guard, Reflex Save. That's nice, but I don't think I'm going to use it. Fortitude Save, sorry, let me use that. That is useful. I think I have somebody who might be able to use that. Nope. I might pass that over to my bard and see. It might be closer to red at least. Wherever it is, there it is. Put that in there. This stuff I'll just throw out here real quick. Just to get out of inventory. Those are outsider tokens, aren't they? Yeah. And my previous voice and mantle went towards my master's gift, so I went ahead and got another mantle after I'm in Delaris at some point and get another voice. At the moment, I'm thinking I need a break, though. I think I'll take a quick break and then run Siegebreaker and then probably call it after that. I did not sleep well last night, and I had that whole not eating this morning. And
for the health screen and all that stuff, and I'm kind of out of it. So looks like we'll end up at about 2 hours, which isn't horrible. But that's where Siegebreaker is. All right. So hang tight. I will be back in 10-ish minutes, I believe. Thanks for watching. Hey, Cordovan, thanks for watching. I am just about back. Alright. Let's do this thing. Quick buffing. Make sure that's on, and let's go ahead and do that.
You emerge from the tunnel among giant
just for the saves.
Chosen this location for the camp.
Poor conscript was turned around. Fear stuff doesn't really work. Oh, dancing does though. You can dance me. Stun damage.
This must be their medical supply. It would be a shame if something vile and poisonous happened to fall into the
Where are you? There you are. Yeah, I don't think I'm really being back here. Couple exterminator, alright. Love that random extra XP from Monster Manual. I like that, dude. I like that massage. Is that nice for you? Yeah. I need to remember to save some of the weapons because I have shroud thingies that need to be charged up.
The
energy cells and such.
This cave is sickening and almost palpable. Is the entire army using it as a latrine?
Probably. I think I'm going to try to do is go this way and have everybody come with me. But yeah. Bucket full of unspeakable. This is such a fun. Yeah, this might be a candidate too, because this has some fun stuff too. I can't remember where you put it, though. There it is.
You dump the unspeakable out of your bucket into the hissing voice of a Medusa echoes in the valley. Where's that kobold? I need his report yesterday.
You can start out with a stone gaze, huh? Stone gaze out again. about to, sounds like. I keep knocking my headphones against this shelf that's right next to my head. It's getting kind of old.
This large half-orc cook smells of bacon. His hot frying
pan smells of bacon. If I could get out of here in any way, that would be cool. Did not get my shine through off in time.
Serves as a field kitchen. Destroying their provisions may cause a food shortage. Soldiers have bunked down in this hallway.
This must be the armor. That's a lot of explosives for one hour.
Switch over to ranged for this section.
That's the biggest barrel of explosives you have ever seen. Careful. What do you know? The second biggest barrel of explosives you've ever seen is here too.
That's hilarious.
Two screaming officers that throw out fall from the hole.
Biggest and second biggest barrels. Brinky and Pain, so this might be a candidate for one of my requests. soon as I can go back to this for a second just to kill some of these barrels.
Still asleep. They're used to loud noises.
Seems like shaking these guys up just to calm down.
Giant temple complex rises.
Go ahead, go down this way just to make sure I don't miss any breakables. Cat, you're not dying. Cat! I don't know what your problem is, you just ate. Now there's water and stuff. Oh yeah, I probably should watch my hit points. Let's go ahead and put this back on. We'll haste again too. Got a lot of shields.
The blood hasn't dried yet on this altar. Who was sacrificed here?
No, thank you.
Humans on Zendrick back during the time of the giant.
Watch it again. Healing, you would have been dead. Okay. Time for the fun part.
The rhythmic sounds of mining picks on stone resound from down below.
I look to be doing, you know what, I'm going to go ahead and rest. Not that I need it. But just to make sure, this last battle thing is interesting. Make sure I get shining through all the way up. Get some buffs on. Let's go ahead and stone skin initially.
Chant echoes from the hole in the floor. This a withered and bent figure stands before you. Surely this confrontation will end quickly.
Solving the quest, you could just, you know, face me one on one. No traps, no tricks, no army. No, don't want to go that way. Well, so my own sleep storm is getting me. That's hilarious. Get out of the way so she can do her thing. I get the temporary, so I don't have to worry about my real enemies. Alright, so
Yeah! of the mission. That'll do just fine. I'll leave you now. But here's one
some decent XP.
Behold the might of Droam!
This is the awesomest, awesomely awesome thing ever. Love the cavalry. They're so fun.
Mission is a success.
Nothing to it.
The few remaining stragglers pose no threat to Zendrick.
Which was that? Pretty good XP. Oh, Astral Shards. So at some point I need to make the Vampiric Stone Dust wraps. So I need the Staff of the Shadow. I've got the Stone Dust Hand wraps and I've got the mark. I need the staff. I have to look up my bank and see if I've got that available. In any case, that was some decent XP. It's been 2 hours. Let me look up the next quest or an LFM real quick, but I think that might do it for today. It's right around the corner. Make sure I turn this in and then the chain. Press the trophy, looks good. Guild needs renown still. So that'll always be good. Hey, look, a Staff of Shadow, I could get that. Dolish Warble, the marks. Staff of Shadow, though. I think I want to get that so that I can actually make the vampiric wraps for my monk. I could just do that all again on hard and get quite a bit of XP again. They aren't bad quests. Darg. Do you put that staff in the bank? Before I forget. Is there anything else I want to pass over? I wanted to pass over marks, probably. Are those in here? Isn't it? Let's make sure those are in the bank. Alright. Get rid of some junk. Look at LFMs. See what we're gonna do.
doing 13s on elite. Anything that's epic, I want to leave until later. Wow, there's not much to choose from, is there? I've done all the 13s on elite that aren't epified. That's it. We need more 13s. I really do. I could do cry for help, but I don't really feel like it. So I think I'm going to call it there. So thanks everyone for watching. This has been Seymourgoo on DDO Stream Twitchy Tuesdays. I'm here most Tuesdays. And also check out Damsel of DDO, which may be on tonight. Cordovan's weekly Wednesday lunchtime live stream tomorrow. We got Titan, Shu, Witsy, and Matson. Gemini's tomorrow evening. Pikers Anonymous, and everybody else who streams on DDO Stream. We do appreciate you watching. Cordovan usually archives or highlights these videos on Twitch if you want to watch replay. I put them on my YouTube if you want to watch a replay there. Available on Twitter, Twitch, of course, on my own channel, Steam, my own website, Discord, and other places. So thanks, everybody. Hope you enjoyed. See you next time. Good night.